During World War I, the U.S. wanted to remain neutral, but after the sinking of a ship, which the Germans bombed thinking it was a subship, the U.S. joined the war. After they had joined the war, there was a massive boom in industrial factories. Even though the government was weak and didn't consider the coherent policies as well, since the U.S. factories were very famous, we were able to ration goods into Europe. It gave women freedom to work in factories since the men were overseas. After World War I, there was a result of many casualties, but the Allies won the war and brought the war to a conclude. To be living during the war in the 20s was a great time. Since the U.S. ranked in an increase of factories and ration goods that made the citizens happy, since many ways of money was used like installment buying in which citizens bought on credit. As for transportation, Henry Ford constructed various techniques for Americans to purchase cars affordable by using the assembly line. As for purchasing food, it was easier to buy since it was cheaper and became available to the public. During the Great Depression, many things went wrong. For example, agriculture during the Roaring Twenties produced a lot of surplus crops, which over the years increased and decreased. Demanding led to less agriculture profits. Villages and cities were suddenly an uneven distribution of wealth because industrial labor income grew slowly, but the workers were working harder, but the business owners became richer and the poor stayed poor. Through this depression, American debt increased and consumer spending also increased. Many events involving the market crash created a stock speculation. Black Tuesday also happened.
Now with a hidey high and a holy
hole. Americans were tired and depressed once the Great Depression hit. But when the 1932 presidential elections were held, Democrat President Franklin Roosevelt told American citizens that he promised to get them out of this depression with three R's, which were relief, recovery, and reform. Through this, the American citizens were happy since they got new jobs. The Japanese attacked Pearl Harbor. Americans were working to become prepared for this war, which shamed them socially because they created the home front to spend less money on useless things, and it helped the war effort more with more weapons. It gave African Americans an opportunity to join in the way which desegregated the army. Through politics during the war, they used various propaganda like posters and radio broadcasts. When World War II ended, there were many soldiers who couldn't find jobs. When the GI Bill was created to provide soldiers to 1 year of employment, college tuition, and loans to house veterans. There is also an increase of population due to the baby boom. Americans finally have jobs, money, and families that grew in the suburbs, which created livelihoods that were available. The Cold War affected America socially by making America become more aware that after World War II, Russia was trying to expand itself into Europe. It affected it economically through the Marshall Plan, in which it helped Americans have great relationships with countries that were against communism. It helped politically through the determined document and opposed communism expansion and made it into American Foreign Policy North Atlantic Treaty Organization, which created a military alliance to counter Soviet expansion. The civil rights movements impacted life in America for all Africans by creating various court cases that desegregated schools, removed literacy tests from voting polls, desegregated bus seats, TV shows, and restaurants.
What is America to me? A name, a map, or the flag?
The war impacted America at home since the American media was portraying that Americans were losing and the government were saying we were winning. Upon soldiers coming home, they were treated poorly because of the media portraying them horribly. It impacted the war abroad since through this war, foreign countries lost a lot of respect for the U.S. because they viewed Americans as being guardians of freedom, which leads to lots of democratic issues. The Vietnam War led to counterculture because during the war there was a huge movement for an anti-war. When this protest took place, many citizens were questioned about traditional boundaries like restrictions on rights or culture and clothing or hairstyles. This heightened the distrust of authorities, which leads them to saying not to trust people over 30. These members were counterculture, valued youth and freedom in their expression. They promoted peace, love, and freedom. In this time period of life, many experimented with change of music, new style of hair and clothing, as well as they were comfortable with their sex life, which also led to drugs.